What's going on, YouTube? This is Necrostevo, and today we have a narrated Wi-Fi battle. Now, I didn't upload this past Saturday. I ended up working like 3 14-hour days in a row, and I kind of just conked out between shifts, getting about 4 or 5 hours between each day. So I'm finally back. Fortunately, I am able to get this upload on Tuesday for you. And Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire are almost upon us, so I'm looking forward to rolling out some more videos this week. This is a battle I had against Lisa, or Ash Fangirl Lisa. Big shoutouts to her. I actually got a chance to meet her in person at PokeCon a couple of years ago, and hopefully I get to see her again next year. But as you can see, she has one of her Ash kind of theme teams there, with the exception, of course, of Quagsire. And I kind of just brought some random things, most notably pairing up Zoroark with regular Rotom, and sometimes Trevenant. This is my Assault Vest Trevenant. It's just really fun to pair Zoroark with those guys, because normal and fighting type moves just don't work. And there's some great synergy there between Zoroark using U-turn and Rotom using Volt Switch. So I get a little bit of synergy there. I admit that I've been misusing Diancie. It took me about 4 battles to realize that Diamond Storm was a physical move. Excuse me. Kind of stupid there. But for those of you who didn't know, Diamond Storm is a physical move. So woo. Outside of that, Eviolite Porygon and Trapping Parish Song Whirlpool Lapras, throwback to second gen, of course. Shoutouts to Vec from Vec and Lex Play. So here in the beginning, I started off with Zoroark. Not a good matchup against Noctowl, just because I can't really hurt it. I switched out expecting a Toxic or something to that degree, but she actually goes on to Quagsire, and so I figured I'd just go straight for Freeze Dry. It's 4 times effective, and most Lapras don't carry it, so I am able to get a surprise KO on Quagsire there. Snorlax, I can't really touch. My only attacking move is an Ice-type move, and if it has Thick Fat, I'm not going to do very much. I decided to try to Parish Trap it, but I take way more from Body Slam than I expected to, and she paralyzes me. So I haven't even trapped it yet, and I can't take additional hits. And here she surprises me with Return, which does even more damage with Body Slam, and I'm unable to go for Whirlpool because I'm paralyzed. So that didn't work out too well. I'm able to go for Protect here. Here I just wanted to force her to switch out. I could have easily switched into any Ghost types at any point here, but I was determined to trap and kill something with Whirlpool, but getting paralyzed kind of threw a wrench in that plan. But now she is forced to switch out, which is good. I'm going to switch out too, because I can save my Lapras for later on for Death Fodder. And I make the mistake of switching out into my Trevenant as she brings in her Charizard. And I'm going to have to go out into Diancie here to take, hopefully, the fire attack. Hopefully she doesn't see that coming and go for the Solar Beam. And she actually ends up going for, I think, Air Slash on my switch. And I wanted to scout to see if she had Solar Beam. And so I'm going to switch yet again, just to see if she has it, because there's no point in risking that. And Porygon can take anything with relative ease here. I trace Drought, which is kind of useless, and she does have Solar Beam, so I'm happy I didn't stay in there with Diancie. I don't think I would have outsped, because Diancie's speed is so sad before it turns into Mega Diancie. I am actually able to also take a Heat Wave with Porygon, which I was very impressed by. Good job, Pixel. You're able to get off some decent damage with the Discharge there. I was hoping for Paralysis, but I don't quite get it. And she just goes for Air Slash instead of the Heat Wave there, just to probably have a better chance of hitting. Here I go out into Zoroark. Now that I've taken off some of its HP, I know a Life Orb Sucker Punch will KO it from that range. It's not Mega Charizard X, so it does not get the defense boost that the Mega Charizard X does get. Unfortunately, I can't really do anything to Snorlax, and I don't really want to take the hit there. And so I decided to U-turn out. Unfortunately, she predicts me to switch and goes for Crunch. So either she didn't realize that it was my Rotom, which I doubt it because I think she knows that Rotom can't learn Sucker Punch. And so that was a fantastic prediction on her part. I just went for Horn Leech there to get some HP back. Snow Ice is nice and fat. And as Chimpak would say, get some yummy HP back there. And I am not going to be able to live another Crunch Attack. That was some min-max damage there or something going on. I just go for Psyshock here with Diancie. I actually expected Venusaur to switch in, so I'm not quite able to get the KO, and she's able to do some fantastic damage with Earthquake. Fortunately, I'm holding the Pixie play and not Life Orb, and Moonblast will be able to finish off Snorlax. I think I was trying out Rock Polish Diancie in this battle. Fortunately, the sun's no longer up, so I don't have to deal with Chlorophyll Venusaur. And Psyshock, I thought was too obvious, and so I went for Diamond Storm. And since this is a timid Diancie with max special attack, it doesn't really do anything, basically. And yeah, I get my energy drain and I waste my Diancie because I'm too dumb to know that Diamond Storm is a physical move. But all that aside, I'm able to go back on a Zoroark. Rotom looks quite silly going for Flamethrower, but I am able to finish off Venusaur. And that basically just leaves Noctowl. So I can KO it eventually with my Zoroark because I have Hidden Power Ice, but I'm going to need to whittle it down a good bit. Now I switch to Emporion here on the Toxic. On the off chance that I get to recover up, I doubt that I'm going to outspeed it though just because Porygon is quite slow. And she is carrying Air Slash. I know that my own Noctowl on, I think both of them, I only carry Nightshade. So I was hoping maybe she was only carrying Nightshade, but this is not the case. I do go out into Rotom. Noctowl takes Thunderbolt quite well because of its great base special defense. And it's able to Toxic me. Unfortunately, it can't take another one, so she's going to kind of be at a loss here as far as taking another Thunderbolt from Voltgeisto. But still, I think she still has her Pikachu left, and I was surprised that she didn't switch it in on Voltgeisto, but I think at the time she didn't remember that she had the Lightning Rod on the Pikachu. So that is actually going to be the end of that match. I think I still had just Zoroark and my Rotom left, so a 2-0, a pretty close match, especially for her using an Ash team there. I think getting the momentum early on by taking out Quagsire with the Freeze Dry is what allowed my team to pull through. So I hope you guys enjoyed this little mishmash of a kind of a random tier match, and look forward to some more Mega Overview videos as we get closer to Omega Sapphire and Alpha Ruby being released. You guys have a great day, and I will talk to you later. Bye-bye now.